Richard, you came with him, you didn't bring it up.
Actually, I think Roy was up there, we just couldn't see him.
From Alex. I didn't hear this, so somebody else might have to tell the story, but apparently there was some commentary concerning pants that didn't go over well with a lot of people. Something along the lines of, guys, just wear whatever kind of pants you have the most fun in.
I will correct that quote, sir. It was,
please do.
However you feel festive in your pants wear.
Wow. I'm kind of sad I missed that.
And it didn't cost anybody any.
That was Silent Night right there.
Okay, so the next two nominations are both for Rob Smith. One of them
is, he here
is
yet?
For arriving.
Is he here yet?
And the second one is, if you didn't get that, the first one was for arriving a little bit late, for one of the chorus calls and for the first show, where we all sort of sang, there's Rob's spot, but there's no Rob.
And he was out starting his camera on the balcony.
Oh, well, that's a good reason. The second one was also during one of the tech rehearsals. Apparently, some of the people were in his way while he was on his way to his quartet. And it did not end well for them. So the next one we're going to throw out there, there are a couple of them that had to do with the program, the show program. The first two sort of go along with another one, so we're going to come back to them later. The next one we're going to come to is for Rick Brower, for incorrectly titling Roy Pritchard as the assistant director instead of associate director. Sort of sketchy, but there's a reason that we didn't make it into the real one. The next one is one that I threw in there. And remember, these are the special nominations. They don't count because they didn't happen during the show, unless you all vote for them. Yeah, that's fine.
Could he spell associate, or was it just easier?
That's just me. How many singles did you bring with you? What did you say?
I said only the first three letters. I'm sorry.
Alright, so the next one, this one's for Pete, and this one, like I said, this one's just because they got it. So Pete wrote me an email with all of his nominations, and in there he said, and I quote, "There's no point in nominating the MC for anything." So with that, we're going to move on to the real nominations. All right, so the first real nomination that we have is for Pete, Mr. Alex. For those of you who missed it or might not have been paying attention during the first show, or was it the second show?
First show.
He was thanking everybody, and he gets to Alex and he says,
"And our show director, Mr. Alex."
Alex Mann. You know what I actually write? Daniel Lambert and Alex Lambert. But, you know. All right, so our next nomination is for. I gave everybody all the real nominations their own little nickname, just so you kind of get the idea of where we're going here. So the next one is Jim. Now seems like an appropriate time to yawn, Fenton. So that one comes because during the Secret of Christmas in the first show.
Is it after 8 o'clock in the morning?
During the Secret of Christmas, somebody saw Jim yawning during the song in front of the audience. So,
hang on, were they looking at the director like they should have been?
We'll get to those later. All right, so next we have, is Richard Bain here?
No.
That's too late.
That's very sad because we have two actual nominations.
Yeah.
I'm well aware. So is the rest of the North. So Richard.
He's not running this party.
Richard's first nomination was Richard, don't screw up my song, Bane. For those of you who didn't hear him say it, in the middle of the show, FX is walking down there and they're getting ready to sing one of his songs. And people audibly heard him say, now this is one of my songs, don't you guys screw it up. On stage in front of the audience.
Yes, did they screw it up?
Yeah, I sure hope they didn't screw it up.
How would you know?
And Richard's other nomination was we're gonna go with Richard.
Ooh, shiny.
Squirrel got caught not watching the director during what song was that? Do you hear what I hear? Just about any.
Sorry, you mispronounced it. He shoots his score. Yes.
All right, moving right along. So our next nomination is for Dan Watch My Moves Clooney's. So there's actually sort of two nominations that got thrown in here, but one of them was for talking right up until the curtain started opening, and then turning around from facing the chorus just in time for half the audience to miss it. And there was also some commentary from the person who nominated you, Dan, and that said that there was a lot of stretching going on that was very distracting. I don't know why it was distracting, but okay.
Look at this.
Demo.
Show us, Dan.
Demo, man.
Hey, I got a buck for you, Dylan.
Wouldn't be the first time.
$1 bills in the room.
Anyway, so our next nomination, we're gonna sort of put two of them together. The first one doesn't really count, but so both of these are for our beloved director. The first one is for almost tripping at the beginning of the second show in her heels. That's what we call a showstopper, and not the good kind. So, the other one...
The catcher.
What's that?
They were lining up the catcher.
That's so rude.
Raffle tickets.
So the second one, and the nickname that goes with this one is, how about a cutoff? That'll spice things up.
Yeah.
And if you weren't paying attention, like some of us apparently.
I was just wanting to make sure that he was watching.
Yeah. Right. You always watch the director, right?
That's right.
So, if your bang wasn't.